So I work at Sauropod Studio on Castle Story for the animation. I'm in charge of making sure that the animation is more of a robust platform to produce more content, add more features to the game so that the character can do more things. Initially, the character, the way he was designed and implemented, he didn't have... He had a good set of initial clips and things he could do, but it was very integrated in pretty messy fashion, directly in the code using an old-fashioned method of starting clips from the code. And this is not really conducive to having to introducing more content and more features and more things that the character can do. So what we did is we rebuilt the platform. In fact, we rebuilt the entire Bricktron from the ground up. One of the layers, one of the lowest layers is the integration of the animations. This is done using the Animator feature from Unity, which is in fact Mechanim. Mechanim is a 3D animation engine for characters and bipeds that is actually working pretty well for us. It has a couple of quirks, but in general it works pretty well. It allows us to author our clips and connect them together and stitch them together in order to produce an animated character. So I work very closely with an animator, with Max, that you've seen previously. And what he provides to me as a foundation, as a building block, is these clips, which are a bunch of keyframes that the character is doing. There's absolutely no intelligence to this. Each clip is just a bit of information that we use. For example, this is hitting a brick low, this is hitting a brick low, this is hitting a brick high. And here what I do is I select a bunch of features that I want to have in my clip. For example, I want this clip to loop, so he's actually looping. One of the features that we use from Unity is the root motion animation. This feature allows us to have an in-place animation so that the character doesn't move around his center of mass. This is pretty useful. So the foundation, the most elementary aspect of the character is a clip like this. What we do is we use these clips. What we author is a controller, which is a large state machine, which represents each different state the character can be in. For example, in place is a blend tree of the different, well, it's just the character in place. Now the character can be in place, but in several different fashions. For example, he can be in place holding a rock. He can be in place holding a barrel. Now there's no barrel, but the character is actually just doing the motions. Holding a bag and holding a brick or a log. These are the ways the character can be animated. From here, you can see it's sort of a star system. What it does is from the idle animation, the character can halt, he can turn on spot, he can do a close step, then he can run, he can walk, and he can run. So in effect, what this looks like in the game is something like this. This is my gym. This isn't the actual game. This is an environment I use to test my animations and produce the content in a quick fashion. So for example, if I tell the character to go over there, he's going to go over there. If you follow here, what he actually does is he's actually, for example, when I'm running, he's going to go through here, here, and here, looping in the different states. For example, now he's running, and now he stops. I can actually do it in slow motion. I can send the character running over there. You can see the different states as they are being run. He's looping in his cycle, and when he arrives, he skids and slides to arrive in position. Now this is one of the types of animations we have. We have the turn on spot, which is pretty neat actually. Very good animations here. We also have the close steps for the small motions of one square. And we have the longer ones, for example, the ones I just shown you for doing the runs. Now all of this is for locomotions. We also have the different interactions that the character can do. So I have a couple of cheat codes here to make my character. Now remember, there is no AI here. This is purely animation. The character doesn't really know what he's doing. I'm just telling him, do this, and he does it. For example, when I press 1 in my test scene, he goes and he starts chopping wood. And I press 1 again, he stops. Press 2, he's going to come out with his hammer. If I press 3, does it with a pick. And also I have sort of a cheat here where this little cube acts as a placeholder for taking things. For now, for example, this is how I test my animations for picking up barrels and stuff like that and all the different things. Also, the barrel is sort of in his face right now, and we're working on making sure that the offsets are right. So really what we're working is creating high quality animation, both for visual content, but for the visual aspect of it, but also to make it easier to create more content because we have great ambitions